What I'd like to say to you is you're crazy, because this is a business where, you know, you cannot predict what will be successful. If I got my publishing done, which obviously is early in the morning, you're halfway there, and I said, tell me what makes a best-selling book, they would not be able to tell you that, because it's something that is so mercurial. You know, it depends on being in the right place at the right time, and all you can do as a writer is write your best book. And sometimes that's not enough. One of my favorite things that I read when I first got published was an interview by Dorothy Allison. And she said the worst thing that can happen to a writer is to get published. And if you think about it, for me, my dream for basically 20 years, so the last 20 years of my life, was to be a published author. And then suddenly I was a published author and I thought, what next? Now, how do you measure success from that point on? I measure success by saying to myself, is this the best book I can write? Is this the story I want to tell? Sales are very nice, but if you really just have as a benchmark that sales is going to define what success is for you, you're never going to feel successful. There's always another book, there's always the next year, there's always something else, there's always a Da Vinci Code, there's always a help. There's always a book that is going to sell far more than you, unless you're J.K. Rowling. And you're really going to do yourself a disservice if you think about the market, if you think about, well, I need to do something with Labradors and Angels because that's what's selling. That's never going to work for you. You have to write the book that you want to write. Someone said you have to write what you know. I think you have to write what you want to know also. And that curiosity is what makes you want to be a writer. I was trying to think of it this morning, just trying to think because it was really early. They asked me to do this, and my publicist said yes, so here I am. What is the advice I would give writers, first-time writers, or you know, just published, other than don't do it, is to read. Because a lot of authors lose sight of why they want to be writers, and we all got our start reading a book and saying, I want to do that. And it really is awful when writers stop reading. You can tell from their work that they've stopped reading. I think the best advice I ever heard anyone give a writer is from Stephen King. And he said for every 2 hours that he writes, he reads a book. You know, and I think that's a good ratio. There are all kinds of brain scans that show reading minds have different pathways from non-reading minds. And if you stop reading, you're closing down those pathways. And don't read to say, I want to be the next Janet Ivanovich, what's your secret formula? Read to entertain yourself, read to enjoy reading. Read for the pleasure of reading, because that's why you want to tell stories. That's the experience you want to give your readers, is that pleasure. And if you don't have the experience yourself, you can't lead your readers down that journey. And so I got an agent. I thought, this is it. You know, I've written this great story of the South, and it was a saga. I had a good murder in it, of course, and not good enough, apparently, because my agent shopped it out, and everyone turned it down. And so I said to her, I really want to see the rejection letters. And she didn't want me to, because she didn't want to listen to me cry, I guess. And so before she went on vacation, she had them sent to me, and all the names were redacted, so I wouldn't call out these people. you know, I read them and held them up to the light to try to see the name, so that I could call them. And what they were saying was, we really like your writing, but the story doesn't work for us. And so my agent got back from vacation, and I talked to her about what's next. And she said, well, what do you want to do? And I said, I've always wanted to write a thriller. And she said, well, write it. If it's good, send it to me. If it's not, then try something else. And so, you know, of course I wrote it, and I thought it was terrific, because I thought everything I did was terrific. And I sent it to her, and those of you with agents know that before you sell something, it takes them about 3 years to read it. So I read my first thrill of Blindside, and actually it was only about 3 months it took her to read it. And she called me up and she said, I think I can do something with this. This is really great. And I said, well, good, because I have written a second one. And she said, well, okay, send it to me. And it took her 3 weeks to read it this time. And she called called me back and she said, well, this is great. I think I can sell the series. And I said, well, you need to sell three because while you were reading it, I did an outline for a third. And she said, okay, I'm going to sell it right now, but you need to stop doing this. I can't. So I just want to tell you guys, do not lose sight of why you're doing this. Do not lose sight of the thrill of telling a story. And if you have 100 readers or 100,000 or a million, you are so lucky to be doing something you enjoy doing. But I had this person come up to me at one of my signings, and everybody gets this where someone says, hey, I'm in high school, do you remember me? Or and sometimes you remember them and you think there's a reason we stop talking. But this woman came up to me and said, I went to kindergarten with you. Do you remember me? And I said, oh, no, I'm sorry, I don't. And she said, well, I remember you. Because when the teacher went around and asked that question, teachers asked, probably because they're looking for something else to do, what do you want to be when you grow up? You and I were the only people, only two kids, who answered that question are actually today doing what we said we wanted to do. And you said you wanted to be a writer, and I said I wanted to be divorced from a very wealthy man.